Freedom Scientific, a Vispero brand.
All right, well, let's just start it off by talking about the Startup Wizard, and I'm going to go ahead and demo that here in just a second. But the Startup Wizard allows you to change a wide range of settings, or basically set up JAWS the way you want it when you install it. So you can change settings for speech rate, punctuation, typing echo, starting JAWS at the login screen, just a wide range of things. Now, the Startup Wizard runs when you first install JAWS, but anytime after that, you can also press Insert J to go to the JAWS window, Alt H for the Help menu, and then Z for Startup Wizard. So I'm going to go ahead and share my screen, and we're going to go ahead and delve into that. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and press Insert J here.
JAWS context menu.
Now I have my JAWS set to run from the system tray. So mine comes up in a context menu. So instead of pressing Alt H, I'm just going to press H.
H command search insert plus.
And then I can press Z to get to the Startup Wizard.
Z leaving menus. JAWS Startup Wizard dialog. Help us improve Freedom Scientific products. Would you like to participate in our effort to improve Freedom Scientific products by submitting anonymous usage data?
Okay, so here on this first screen, there are several screens here in the Startup Wizard. So here on the first screen is a checkbox about anonymous data usage. Now, this data is simply used to improve our products and also improve the experience for you, the user. So we don't save this information, we just use it to make those improvements in our products. Now, you need to have this box checked in order to use certain features like Picture Smart and Voice Assistant, which we'll tell you about those here in just a little bit. So I am going to verify here.
Participate checkbox checked.
I pressed Insert Tab, by the way, because when you enter the screen, you're automatically on that checkbox, and mine is checked. So from here, we can tab to move through the dialogue here.
Anonymous data collection policy link.
And if you want to read that policy, you could, or you can go on.
Privacy policy link. Next button.
Let's go to the next button. I'm going to press space to go to the next screen.
Space. Speech settings. Rate 68.
Now here we have speech settings. So again, you just press the tab key to move through these settings. When you're on, for example, when you're in a box like this where you can change your speech rate, you can use your up and down arrow keys.
26%.
I pressed up arrow, I'll press down arrow.
25%.
Now I can tab to the next speech setting.
Punctuation combo box.
And it's on some. I could press up and down arrow to change the punctuation setting here. Let's see, we can just tap through a couple more of these here.
Typing echo characters radio button checked.
Now you heard it say radio button checked. So typing echo is what happens when you type, let's say you're in Microsoft Word, for example, and you type, are you going to hear the characters, words, both characters and words are none. So with the radio button, you can just use your up and down arrow keys once again to change that setting. If you have a checkbox, you're going to use your space bar. So here in the Startup Wizard, we won't go through all these settings, but you can just keep going through these screens by tabbing to the next button, pressing the space bar, and then eventually you get to the last screen and there's a finish button, and you can just press enter a space on the finish button to close the Startup Wizard. If you're in the Startup Wizard and you don't want to finish, you can go to cancel, which I'm going to do by pressing Shift Tab because
punctuation rate 68 left cancel button to activate press space
bar. So I can just press space bar to cancel here.
Space.
All right. So that is the Startup Wizard. Like I said, you just press Insert J, then to go to the JAWS window, Alt H for help, and then Z, Zulu, for the Startup Wizard. Now let's talk a little bit about the basics that you'll find, the basic settings you'll find under Options menu. So here you'll find some basic settings which include tutor messages, which you just heard JAWS announce, you know, to press your up and down arrow keys or to type text or use your arrow keys to read text. So those are your tutor messages. You'll also find a prompt to confirm when exiting JAWS. You'll find some automatic startup JAWS or automatically starting JAWS information, keyboard layout, just a number of things. So to get to the basic settings, you're going to press Insert J again to go to the JAWS window, Alt O for options, and then Enter on basic, which is the first item there. So once again, I'm going to press insert J.
JAWS context menu to navigate.
And I'm on options, so I'm going to press enter.
Enter basics dot dot dot.
And I'm going to press enter on basics because once again, I'm using JAWS is running from the system tray. So.
Enter leaving menus, basic settings dialog, tutor messages, announce menu and control help radio button checked.
Okay, so if I want to turn this off, for example, I can use my up and down arrow keys. I'm going to press up arrow.
Tutor messages, turn off menu and control help radio button checked. 1 of 3, alt plus T.
Now, that should turn off the tutor messages. And like the other dialog here, just like the startup wizard, I can use the tab key to move through this dialog.
Access key, speak all radio button checked. 2 of 4.
And that's a radio button. So again, your up and down arrow keys can be used to go through those options.
Automatically start JAWS dot 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 button.
Now that's a button, and if you press space on it, you'll get all of your choices for starting JAWS on the login screen, starting JAWS after login for all users or specific users. So that's how you would get to those settings.
Prompt to confirm when exiting JAWS checkbox checked.
Now that's a checkbox, so I'm going to leave it checked because I want JAWS to prompt me if I exit JAWS, but you could press space to uncheck it.
Automatic notification of updates checkbox checked.
I want that.
Run JAWS from system tray checkbox checked.
And mine is checked there.
Show virtual viewer on screen checkbox checked.
And
use keyboard layout combo box laptop.
So let's say you want to change the layout of the keyboard layout. For example, if you were using a desktop computer or a regular keyboard, you had it on desktop. Now you have a laptop and you don't have a numpad, for example. I mean, you want to be able to use the caps lock as your insert key. You can go here and change it to laptop. And you can just use your arrow keys to navigate through that box there.
Windows system parameters. Dot, dot.
And I'm going to tab.
OK button.
To OK. And I'm going to press the Enter key. So that's just the basics there. And once again, you'll see a lot of these settings overlap in different places. You'll find the same settings in different places.
Freedom Scientific, a Vispero brand. To stay up to date on upcoming webinars and training events, complete the sign-up form at freedomscientific.com/webinars. Thanks again for connecting with us.